Hello, everyone. Continue to pray for my health, for our finances, for worldwide salvation. Always pray that you're found worthy. Pray for a family struggling to get food. They need food. If anybody can help, please let me know and I can get you in contact with her or whatever. Also, for my friend Bobby's health. Trying to think if there's anything else. Can't think of anything. If you have prayer, please let me know. I feel like I look like crap. I try to make myself look nice, but I feel like I don't. All right, Letting Go and Trusting God, 180 Devotions for Life's Tough Decisions by Pamela L. McQuaid. All right, today's topic. Is thorny issues. Then Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, gave this order to the Hebrew midwives, Shifra and Puah. When you help the Hebrew woman as they give birth, watch as they deliver. If the baby is a boy, kill him. If it is a girl, let her live. But because the midwives feared God, they refused to obey the king's orders. They allowed the boys to live too. Exodus 1:15-17. The Hebrew midwives faced a terrible choice. Did they obey Pharaoh or did they do what they knew was right and let the male Hebrew babies live? Their lives and livelihoods could be on the line, but because these women feared God more than Pharaoh, they did the right thing, then lied to Pharaoh when he confronted them about these living boys. The midwife situation may remind us of the thorny issues we live with today. There may be no good, honest way out of them. If we are faithful to one, we shortchange another. God never punished the midwives for lying. Instead, God was good to the midwives, and because the midwives feared God, he gave them families of their own. Verses 20-21. They had balanced the honor they owed the king with the obedience due to God and got it right. No doubt these women had prayed diligently about their actions and discovered that saving many lives was the most critical need. Then they probably asked forgiveness for their lack of truth. We may know the scriptures and still struggle, but as God led Shifra and Puah in the right way, he can lead us too. And us as Christians need to be praying for these millions of babies that are murdered through abortion and stuff, and take action. If there's an abortion mill near you, go and stand and preach and stand for the babies. Yeah, I think that's it. So I hope you have a great rest of your Friday. God bless you.